Everybody wants to be in the lubricant seat.
Check one, two.
Kvällens pop i fokus handlar om den tyska orkestern Kraftwerk. Deras inflytande kan spåras både i hiphop och modern pop och dansmusik, men Mats Wigedal, syntspelare, Kraftwerk-kännare och gäst här i pop i fokus ikväll, är de verkligen viktigare än Beatles?
Nej, det skulle inte jag vilja säga om man nu ska rangordna saker, men de har varit otroligt viktiga för stora delar av den moderna musiken sen, ja, början på 80-talet och framåt, så har det varit ett otroligt viktigt band.
Varför? Vad är det som gör Kraftwerk så speciella?
Ja, de lyckades väl vara pionjärer i sin genre. Traktera instrumenten och skriva låtar som har lyckats överleva. De har ju nästan vuxit sig starkare och starkare, och det är ju rätt ovanligt. Att band kommer igen efter en tid, det finns ju, men de har ju aldrig blivit ute på något sätt.
Kraftwerk är ett väldigt mytomspunnet band. Varför det?
Ja, det är nog en av dem själva skapat, eftersom de har framträtt väldigt lite med sina, vad ska jag säga, personligheter och hållit sig i det dolda väldigt, väldigt mycket och odlat den myten på så sätt.
Det har gått konflikter inom bandet.
Ja, Wolfgang, Flür och Karl Bartos slutade bandet på 80-talet, och Wolfgang Flür har skrivit en bok som han har blivit stämd för av de återstående i Kraftwerk, och det skapar naturligtvis konflikter.
Mm. Kraftwerk har ju under hela sin karriär haft kommunikation som huvudtema på sina album, om det sen har varit radiosignaler, tåg, datorer eller mode. Har varierat. Kommunikation är däremot inte gruppens grundare Florian Schneider och Ralf Hütters starkaste sida. De har ingen telefon till studion och de svarar varken på e-post eller brev. Därför fick vår reporter Malik Bendjelloul resa till Düsseldorf för att spåra dem och andra gamla medlemmar som Karl, Bartos och Wolfgang Flür. Här kommer programmet om Kraftwerk. Varsågoda.
We had this concept, reducing things rather than blowing things up, reducing to the core.
What is interesting to talk about? What is interesting to talk about which is unusual to normal boy meets girl themes, you know?
We rather discover music as pictograms, very simple motives like don't smoke.
Es ist rot. Das ist verboten. Verboten to go on red.
This was also the fields where we went to the restaurants in the evenings after Kraftwerk. Here on the Oststraße there had been some restaurants, and an ice cream shop was the famous Palantini over there in the Graf Adolf Straße. And a parallel Straße is the Königsallee with the famous Café Bittner where we always had breakfast, you know.
We were living in the British occupied zone. And we were dominated by English and American radio, basically. And we had to find our own identity. So we had this famous German movie artist, Rainer Werner Fassbinder, director. And he did the movie to the Bundesrepublik. Josef Beuys making the art. And we felt we should make a statement how this Bundesrepublik, this Deutschland, would sound. We were listening to Stockhausen. He's one of the biggest influences.
I also think that Kraftwerk made very interesting music. The drive for unusual forms and surprise. So this aspect of openness of the young character is what I like.
Ja, Kraftwerk är ju den stora inspiratören för min del, så att säga, som bara får lov att bli en inspiratör, för man kan aldrig göra om det de har gjort liksom, en gång till, men man kan Man kan vinka lite till dem ibland och sen ibland kan man bara ha dem i hjärtat.
I love Kraftwerk. I mean, certainly some of Kraftwerk's albums are some of my all-time favorite albums, you know, like Man Machine and Computer World. I think those are remarkable, wonderful records.
They found a way to make music with machines and actually were proud of it. They weren't trying to hide it. I think Kraftwerk's music is very cold, but it's also very, very warm. And I think they reached a very interesting balance that hadn't been reached before between the two.
Kraftwerk bildades 1969 av två musikstudenter, Ralf Hütter och Florian Schneider. Efter några år anslöt sig Karl, Bartos och Wolfgang Flür, men efter ett drygt decennium och sex skivor tillsammans lämnade Karl och Wolfgang Kraftwerk. Det är nu 16 år sedan, och sedan dess har bara en enda ny låt lämnat Klingklangstudions väggar.
Have you tried to contact them anyway?
I have, through the record company. I don't know how...
And what did they tell you?
They didn't tell me anything. I didn't give an answer.
I thought so. My friend asked me today, why does he not ask Ralf and Florian? I said, he won't get in contact to them.
They are still working in Klingklang Studio.
Yes, I'm sure. At the moment, they are pretty often in the studio. I sometimes see them from the distance when I come through the Graf Adolf Straße on the Mintrop Platz. And friends of mine tell me sometimes that there is something going on.
How do you contact into the studio?
You can't. You can't. There is any ring from them with no name is to ring inside, but they have always video watched you, you know.
Vi vet alltså så här mycket att det här är Klingklangstudion någonstans i det här gula huset här, men jag vet inte riktigt var. Alltså Kraftwerks kundmedlemmar har fått frågan, de har inte gjort någon tv-intervju på väldigt många år. Men nu är vi alltså här utanför, så då borde det kanske... Här har vi då inte Klingklangstudion.
The Klingklang Studio in Düsseldorf, close to the railway station.
We made jokes. Who had the best joke today? And we met during the afternoon, like maybe 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock. It gets late. It got later and later and later after.
What I didn't like all these years that we always met late and worked until the early morning, you know. Because I'm a day man, not a night man.
Who in Kraftwerk was the night person?
Ralf most, yes, absolutely. When I sometimes visited him in his house at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, he made breakfast just, you know, he was just in his sleeping robe, you know.
So Ralf was the person you had to adjust yourself to. He was the leader.
Absolutely. Even if they always tell it's Ralf and Florian, but I think Ralf is the most intellectual one, and he had the last word mostly. Melody making, lyric making, and theme finding, that was mostly Ralf and Florian. He was mostly into the technical things, absolutely. He brought the first vocoder into our studio. It was a military device. And Karl, later, he was more and more slowly involved into music and melody making as well. And I had two fields, drumming and design making. I made most of the stage sets and the devices. When I met Ralf and Florian, they had some electronic things, not too much at that time, just 3 or 4 electronic things. And Ralf owned already his first Mini Moog. That was the great release for me when I heard and listened to the Mini Moog. It was just this fat sound of the ring modulators, you know. If you take a guitar, it's always the same. You just can make it more bloom, 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 like in the mid-age, or you can make brang, 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 like Mr. Townsend does, maybe, you know. But if you tune the volumes and the filters and the LFOs, you can bring millions of sounds out of it. It's incredible, you know.
The rumble. Harmonica. Yeah. It's gone. Aha. No, I don't recognize this.
It's Kraftwerk.
Autobahn, yeah, yeah.
the press.
They laughed at us. They told us a crazy Knöpfchendreher. You know what a Knöpfchendreher is? Someone who is a bit weird in his mind, and you know, let him do. There comes nothing out of it. But he's nice, but not important. It was too new.
Autobahn went to number 3 in America. It was, let's say, a white audience. College kids liked it. The strange sound and electronics and Autobahn, driving on the Autobahn.
Kraftwerk war genau die Musik für uns. Da war ich so 20, 25 Jahre. War das die Musik gewesen? Zum Beispiel dieser Begriff Autobahn. Man war frei. Man konnte sich mit dem Käfer auf die Autobahn hängen und dann Autobahn. Dam, 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 immer den Mittelstreifen. Das haben die also unheimlich gut toll getroffen.
The radio activity was very different. What only a few people know is that it had nothing to do with the radioactivity as radium. It had something to do with the activities of the radio companies in America.
We were at the Billboard during this first America tour, and there was one line, radioactivity, and it meant the airplay. So we thought about this, how it really makes sense in German, radioactivity, Radioaktivität.
That was a theme. Suddenly it was in their brains when we had been on the back flight. As I heard Ralph and Florian, or Ralph and Karl, no, Ralph and Emil speaking about radioactivity is in the air for you and me.
Radioactivity is in the air for you and me.
So this is Berger Alley, by the way. Die Berger Allee Nummer 9. And in the end is our flat where we used to live together for 10 years, from 73 until 83. This is it, number 9. I lived on the left side, and Emil lived on the right, in the right room, you know. Karl was in the back side, which is very far away on the other side of the house. From this window, I could see the Rhine and all the ships. I loved that place.
Vi befinner oss just nu på järnvägstationen i Düsseldorf. Här gick på 70-talet den transeuropeiska expressen, ett tåg som blev inspiration och tema till Kraftwerks sjätte skiva, Trans Europe Express.
This sleeve was done for the American market.
Was that taken like one picture?
No, there is, it's a combination. It's four pictures actually, and retouched, because if you see, the perspective is different. Florian, his head is much bigger than ours. And this one is retouched also. This is typical Germany. This is supposed to be give an impression of a German string quartet. And this is the River Rhine here, supposed to be. It's a very German environment.
Trans Europe Express. Trans.
The idea about Express. Trans Europe Express was rather to express our German identity. We wanted to incorporate the idea of Europe. And it's a funk rhythm. Tudum cha, bum bum cha, tudum cha, bum bum cha. And we like the idea of incorporating this word trance. So it was very funky then. Trans Europe Express.
This is my favorite album anyway. It's because of its romantic melodies. It's a part of me. This was one of the most reasons why I entered Kraftwerk, because there was something inside of me which touched my heart.
Europe, endless.
The press, the media, to me, the media is like a mirror.
And if you read like NME or newspaper, they tell you what you are, in a way. And people keep on telling us, or kept telling us, they are like robots. They're acting like robots. They don't move. They are showroom dummies. They are robots. They are themselves. They are machines. So we thought, okay, if they consider us as machines, so let's make songs about the connection between man and machine.
We had to look like it sounded, you know. If you think that big and huge American rock circus, how they appeared on stage with jeans on, with holes inside, long hair, drinking lots of whiskey and beer before, it's a macho field with macho movings. And we didn't want that, you know. We all are, in our personalities, a part of, we have feminine attitudes, every one of us, I think. And this was good for us because it kept us more, a little more elegant. We wanted that elegant style.
She's a model and she's looking good. I'd like to take her home, that's understood.
We go to the Nordrhein-Westfalen Forum. This is a museum of modern art where they show special exhibitions, and now it is the Anton Corbijn exhibition, a photographer from Netherlands, who made some very nice photos of pop arts from all over the world. They show also me. Was hinten an der Wand hängt von der Gruppe Kraftwerk.
Ja.
Jetzt bin ich mit der jungen Frau und ihm hier. Wir wollen nur kurz mich vor meinem eigenen Bild
zeigen. Okay.
Dann sind wir auch schon wieder weg.
There are lots of people I know. Isabella Rossellini. Miss Foster.
This is Karl with his Mr. Spock's haircut. Raumschiff Enterprise, Mr. Spock with a thin ear and this haircut.
Ralph looks so sad. Why does he look so sad?
And you?
The first. It's not my own face, it's the face of the dolls.
Who said he was the dolls?
I don't know. One word gives the other and suddenly it appears the idea. Why don't we take dolls instead of us? From that date, we were not needed anymore. There are huge differences. There are huge differences between him and me. And that time I had a nice face. Today I have more in my brain. I was so childish then. But I remember the time. I liked everything with Kraftwerk then. We had been playing in Venice. Then we put the dolls in the audience. The dolls were sitting in the audience and we were playing and they watched us. Yes, that was a good idea. And you know, the funniest thing about that, it was in the first row and it was in the Venice Hall where they normally do the film days there, you know, the Biennale. So there was a very, very famous and a very, very expensive audience. And you know what the first row costs on the places? We had to pay for these first four places for the dolls afterwards. And this was crazy expensive.
If you have a strong theme developed, in the beginning from Autobahn or Radio Activity, all these themes were already there at once because we knew we are doing the soundtrack of the information society. After Man Machine, we had Computer World. It was also very easy to progress from Man Machine to Computer World because we were aware that this is gonna change the society completely again, the electronic revolution. But by the time we did Computer World, we hadn't got one computer in the studio. We had to go to IBM to look at computers.
1, 2, 3.
Plant Rock, bonus beats. They ripped my beat off. Bloody bastards. Well, this guy, Africa Bambaataa, he took the melody from Trans Europe Express and combined it with the beat of Computer World and Numbers and with some rap vocal style. And he claimed this is the beginning of hip hop.
I didn't know what was going on then. I didn't know that they used samples because we had no sampler in that time in Düsseldorf or in Germany. So later on, I didn't like it. I really disliked it at first. Oh, I have to go here. I disliked it, and today I think a bit different. Because otherwise it helped very good to get Kraftwerk into the public ear in America, much more than Autobahn, you know.
Kraftwerk were the biggest influence ever on me. The first album that I actually bought for myself was Autobahn. And the original Autobahn cover is the German Autobahn sign. And that had a really, really, really profound effect on me.
I think in realms of electronic music, I mean, Kraftwerk were by far the most influential band. I mean, you can't really think of like any electronic band that isn't in debt to them in some way whatsoever.
The Man Machine and then the Computer album was seen from my side today. Was nearly the finish, was nearly the end of Kraftwerk. Seen from my side, it was the headline, both albums, I think, the headline of Kraftwerk. And afterwards, Ralf and Florian were much more involved into their cycling, and then it took years to go to the next album.
I remember Florian was the first one who came with a really cool biking race, all metallic. And so it looked so beautiful, then we all bought one. And we went on biking and we stuck to it.
Basically, that's the ultimate Man Machine, isn't it?
Yes. After the Man Machine, you started recording a little bit slower.
Oh, not a little bit slower, man. That was very, very slow. That was years of nothing, you know. And you can listen what came out of it. The last album, which was only called Coffee, as I say.
It got slower and slower. For a certain amount of time, we lost track to creativity and kept on concentrating on technology. And that was the main mistake. So, and in the end, I had to make a little adjustments and leave this band.
Ralf and Florian.
They are crazy. Crazy, very outstanding personalities. They were founding the band. And I was like the youngest. I'm the youngest, so I'm always little color. It changed. I was more bossier in the end. And but you know, I had to leave then in the end because your elder brothers, they never would allow you to come up with leading ideas.
I saw Florian yesterday, by the way. I had been in an electronic shop here, a new one. And went out and suddenly we went parallel, he with his little daughter. And I think we looked each other for a second or so, and then he took his daughter, went on the other side of the street. He was afraid to see me. I said to myself, poor boy, you could have said, good tag. Maybe just good tag.
Hello, is this Heidi Wellen?
Yes, it is.
I would like to speak to the person who has the contact with Kraftwerk.
To be honest, nobody has contact with them. I tried a couple of times, but you don't get an answer.
Really?
Really. I'm very, very honest with you, but that is Kraftwerk. You can't compile them with any other band.
Can you make a phone call to the Kling Klang studio?
Nope. They're not using their phone. They have no phone.
Could you write them a letter? But if you really, really need to come in contact with them, how do you do?
To get in contact with them, some of our company drove to Düsseldorf and waited in front of the studio. And good luck, they arrived the same day. At least Ralf arrived the same day. Otherwise, maybe he will stand there till today.
So here we are. I have gone millions of miles of times, I think, through that door, which goes, if you open it with a special knack, it starts, you know. I have it already stored in my brain. I should sample this knack once and put it into another song, I thought so, you know. No, it's closed. Klingklang is not working.
Don't you think Ralph and Florian is there right now?
No.
Why?
Too early. They work in the evening always.
But tonight you think they will be there?
Yes. This is the one. This is where you have to ring.
There is the number to Kraftwerk.
Is it crazy?
If I listen, I don't listen, but if I listen and I hear an old song like Radioactivity, it sounds so romantic to me. It's just so human. If you consider it to techno music, which it sounds really staccato, inhuman, and this old Kraftwerk music is so human.
Mats Wigedal, håller du med Karl Bartos som ser nästan ett litet romantiskt skimmer kring just det här ljudbild?
Ja, det är många som anklagar för att vara kyliga och kalla, men jag skulle säga att de är väldigt, som Björk säger, väldigt varmt och romantiskt band. De sysslar mycket med treklanger i dur, och då blir det romantik. Lättsam romantik.
Men så uppfattades de inte riktigt från början?
Nej, men man måste komma ihåg, om man har åldern inne, att slutet på 70-talet var de väldigt kontroversiella. Bara att ha kort hår då gjorde att de var väldigt udda. De påminner mest om filmstjärnor från 30-talet. Och att de hade en aura av någon slags lyxiös, intelligent, intellektuell musik. I kontrast mot all engelsk, amerikansk rock då, som var väldigt pompös, var stora sammanhang, var massa instrument, var mycket gitarrer, var larm. Vad gjorde de? Jo, de, som Bartos säger, reducerade, hade små maskiner att spela på. Och det tror jag många då var kontroversiellt.
Det har gått nästan 15 år sedan de släppte sitt senaste album, Electric Café. Varför tror du att det dröjer så lång tid för dem att få färdigt ett nytt? För det påstås ju att de håller på där inne i Klingklangstudion.
Mm. Man kan ju gissa att det är någon slags ångest över sin egen myt. Att vara pionjärer och vara elektroniska genier. Då. Så att som skapar någon slags kanske skrivarkramp. Och...
Mm. De kanske inte borde släppa något med dem kanske. Nej, det kanske fortsätter att vara tysta liksom.
Ja, det kanske det de känner, att de är så, de kanske har förälskat sig i myten om sig själva, så att de vill inte få dem bli krackelerade genom att släppa något som inte uppnått i deras storverk. Jag personligen tycker att de skulle bara göra musik och strunta i den här idén om att göra den perfekta skivan. Jag tycker inte det är så intressant, utan folk gillar deras låtar, tror jag. Deras musik framförallt. Inte så mycket konceptet, utan det som överlever, det är ju musiken.
Ja, vi får se om det blir något mer från Kraftwerks Klingklangstudio i Düsseldorf. Tack Mats Wigedal för att du kom hit. Pop i fokus är tillbaks nästa vecka igen, samma tid. Vi ses då. Hej då.
Say bah.